আমার জয়ের মা। Today the session is very significant for the reason that apart from the conventional theoretical implantations by means of lectures we used to just explain what is the basis of energy and what are all the effects of energy and how to procure that energy and to how to augment and to create a sustainable source of energy within the inner self. So all of these things are just like I have just told in one computer oriented lecture, I just told that generalization of any concept, that is just an introductory burst, and that results to be giving an idea of what we are going to do in future. So without introduction nothing will be useful, and with mere introduction also nothing is going to be useful. So we are going to create such a series of knowledge inculcation in which we start with introduction, we are not being sustained, and ending with the introduction itself. So while introduction is going on, depending upon the person's previous experience and graspability of a conceptive order as well as torrential flow of a language, phraseology, lexicography or verbology, whatever you call, depending upon the person's imbibition skills and inhibition skills of understanding the language, understanding arithmetology and arismology. Arismology is a technical terminology. So to understand English is entirely different from understanding a technical terminology. For example, if you say osmosis, a mere English scholar having known the English knowledge by literary sources like reading Wellesen, Longfellow, Wordsworth, so by mastering literary pieces one cannot come across osmosis. So physics, knowledge about physics is essential for understanding that thing. Like enthalpy is a chemical word. Unless the person is mastered or at least having a basic acquaintance with chemistry, he cannot understand. So it requires, number one, attention. Number two, your own ambition in knowing things. And acquaintance, already having known some things. And deep emergency and thirst inside your mind to know that. And fifth, at least a base of the terminologies both in linguistic and technical backgrounds. So it requires all of these things. So it is just to give an idea for you that there is such a vast ocean in which you can take a morsel and in which you can take a sip, by which you can gradually, by a piecemeal methodology, apprehend these things and practice for universal welfare. So this is very essential. Now we have come to the second portion, maybe the first practical lesson of its kind in the world or in my life at least. So it requires two portions. One is a generalized portion, second is a customized portion. Generalized portion is 1/3 and customized portion is 2/3. If I generalize the process of healing or understanding these things, they require a general phenomena which is common for all people, irrespective of their knowledge, irrespective of their mental balance, irrespective of their physical sturdity, irrespective of their ecological balances, irrespective of the persons. Interest and other things, generally there are some common things which on basis of requirement everybody can be entitled to go inside, and depending upon the other variations it may take some time. So the variation is not in the conceptive digestion but in time for accumulating those things. So there are various factors, you know, that now the office which they have been mechanically doing before, now also they are semi-mechanical, and they consider creating an artificial system of conduciveness. That science is known as ergonomics. Ergonomics is the science of creating artificial conduciveness by which the person can do continuous work, torrential work, perennial source of work, like a bullock, like a horse. Even those animals, they are given rest and they don't have any part time or overtime or overload and other things. These rational animals, being very much severely and tenaciously engaged in the process of money accumulation, even by selling the greatest values of patriotism, sensitivism, altruism and cosmopolitanism, this thing is completely engaged in the process of money accumulation. The second thing is that ergonomics, the science that deals with artificially how to make. See, somebody always being with a computer or with a typewriter in earlier times within official atmosphere, they feel they are not so much having the desire of being inside, but as it is having consequential attachment. Nobody is interested in reading or studying in schools. Then why everybody is going there? Because it is not immediate attachment. It is mediate and remote attachment. So if you study and if you love chemistry, physics and mathematics, that is immediate attachment. You don't like them, but unless you study, you will not be graduated. Unless you will be graduated, you won't be qualified to get into a job. Unless you are getting a job, you cannot earn money. Unless you can earn money, you cannot live a comfortable and luxurious life. So in the order of getting luxury, comfort and convenience in life, the threshold or the primary step is education. So even though you don't want that benefit, immediate benefit, you are interested in the immediate and remote benefit. That is why you are attached with this. Likewise, in armies also, nobody is interested in work. They are very much interested in entertainment rather than enlightenment. So this is the nature of human being. For example, if water must flow down, nothing is required, because naturally there is a gravity which pulls everything down. It is a natural phenomenon. It is innate. Second thing, if you want water to flow up, it requires a pressure by a motor, by a compressor motor or by an artesian spring which naturally has a geostatic pressure. So that thing which is not there innately, that requires a pressure. So anybody getting into entertainment is a natural gravity of mind. To go to cinema, to enjoy music, to dance, to eat, all of these instincts are biological instincts which are abundant with people. They don't require any extra pressure. But if you want to do the contrary thing, intellectual enlightenment, memory boosting, realizing about God, knowing about the fundamentals of universe and developing one's own energy sources, as those things are positive, they require, they are also innate. They are ultimately innate. These things are peripherally innate. See, the soul, naturally it has the thirst for God, love for God. But that is covered and clouded by a peripheral illusory avarana or achadana we call, that is known as a curtain. So that peripheral things that gives you that instincts, the real soul, it has the thirst for knowledge, it has thirst for God and everything, eternity, purity and everything. Understood? So likewise, artificially now in offices, what do they make? In ergonomics, they create a small park-like thing, they create greenery, they create movies watching and billiards and indoor games, and also some restaurant, some facilities to talk and communicate with people, some sort of interactive discussions with people, taking them on entourage, like all of these things artificially they have made to create a conducive atmosphere. Whatever I say, just there is a small thing. While you go for walking, more than the walking process is an addictive process. The addictive process is, while you are walking on a road, you are seeing greenery, you are seeing a vast space. You see, it is known as optical perception. If you see a vast space, if you see thousands of trees, if you see hundreds of birds, if you see humptins of flowers, that seeing in multitude and magnitude and varieties, that creates you a broad-mindedness, a great view to make your mind more deep, dense. We follow that. So if you walk in a walking machine, there are also a lot of walking machines inside. And that is known as a domestic gymnasium, in which they made everything available within a small 10 by 12 room. So if you walk there or walk within your office corridor, that will not give you the equivalent benefit of the ecology. So the ergonomics which they are making as artificial conduciveness in offices, that is not suitable to the natural ecological system. Likewise, coming in the early morning like this time, number one, you have come in this early morning, for that 5 marks. For that itself, God will give you 5 marks. Because we are following the rules of nature. That's what I used to say in one examination oriented lecture. I went there. I said, you are just selecting physics period, chemistry period, biology period, mathematics period. You are selecting as per your own convenience in the daily tabulation, in the schools. And you want the people to say that. There is a natural chemistry time in your brain. Whether you can follow that or not, that is subjected to your own personal convenience. It cannot be adapted in academics. The mind or the brain's work. For example, at some time we can take more food, sometimes little food, sometimes saltless food, and sometimes semi-cooked food, sometimes pure raw vegetables, and sometimes drinkables and beverages. So likewise, it is classified. Likewise, in our brain also, when you can understand arithmetic progressions, when you can understand the evolutions of biology, chemistry and chemical equations, so there is a time. Likewise, it is a time for assimilation of divinity and concepts. So already you are having struggle and lot of difficulties with non-cooperation from physical and mental bodies. And if time is also non-cooperative, you have to struggle more. So this time, in earlier time 4 to 6, that is very cooperative. But at that time dawn, we are not so prepared, but we will be gradually preparing ourselves. What? That is time cooperation. Then the position in which we are seated like this. So putting all of your weight in the Merudanda, that makes you to create a grip in the medulla oblongata region by which the Sushumna is vetified. By means we are capable of learning and imbibing more. The system has been totally abolished by the European culture of sitting and writing in dress and all of these things. And then, and also in empty stomach, if totally we are hungry, we cannot practice anything. If we are fully packed and stuffed inside, we cannot learn anything. So it must be a mediocre. Before hunger comes, or in a position where we can manage hunger, or in a position where we can give preference to knowledge more than hunger, that time is very suitable and conducive. Likewise, we are in a good spiritual ergonomical background, and the place is also, you see, there is good granary, and it is a hut-like structure, and it is a place where a lot of people, they have done their contemplation, meditation and mystic practices. So all of these things are additives which make us certainly to reach the goal which we are here demanding or desirous or deserving to get. Okay, we can start with the program. In the previous lecture, those who attended, they must have heard about the different types of healing. I just told a lot of healing systems, thousands of healing systems, in which we were mentioned a few 20 or 30 systems we have mentioned. Likewise, we have to start with the healing, how to heal one's own self and how to heal others. It is not an instantaneous project. So you must not take this project as today's project is learning and tomorrow it is healing. So this is unimaginable, but it is a threshold, we can start that. So there are three types of people. One type of people, those who are engaged in the process of spiritual healing. Number two, those who are engaged in the process of other systems of healing, who wants the additive benefit of spiritual healing also. The third thing is persons who are business entrepreneurs, business magnates, academicians, professionals, those who want the healing system as a way of service to the society or at least to their family or their personal selves. Could you follow that? So that's what I told, one third is general. After finishing that one third, I have to classify all of you and put you into batches. Then by this 10 or 12 lessons, we will be completing the BTEC in bioenergy. That syllabus will be formed and that will be a contribution of the Supra Foundation for the world. The first time, the first thing of its kind. So generally I have to classify all of you and give general introduction. Today also these practicals are general practicals. General theory, customized theory. General practicals, then specific practicals, exclusive practicals. So these practicals are also of three types. So now we have to start with that. Depending upon the person's caliber, I have to put, what is your taste? You like bitter or you like sweet or you like sour, salt, what is your taste? What is your color? That is not your complexion. What is the color that you prefer? And what is the nature of your appetite bearing, your digestion, your physical, you are sentimental, you are emotional, you are sensational, all of these backgrounds by which we can create you a common category. For example, there are common criteria by which they are put into phylum in biology, like Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Platyhelminthes, Echinodermatis. It is a phylum study. Likewise, it is also an antophylum study in which the persons are the basis of their action, interaction, reaction, counteraction, response, reply and reverberation, they must be put in columns and they have to be given names. They belong to that group. So there are 12 major groups, like 12 zodiac signs, and there are 12 subgroups. They are known as Upadhyaya, and they totally constitute 144 major groups, which are further divided into the power of 144. So these things, main category 144, we can go and we can finalize the numbers, put them into groups and start the specific type of healing. Specific type of healing is for the person. Exclusive type of healing is for the disease or for the person who is the beneficiary. Okay. Now we can start with the process of healing in a particular subject. As discussed earlier with Sujata, we have been calling a lot of diseases are there. That which is having a larger and a tremendous impact in the society, where each and every person is dying both by the disease and also by the fear of the disease, you have to take such fatal as well as the fatalistic diseases that is there adorning the society now in multitude, both quantitatively and qualitatively. and that which has poor services, and that which has lot of mysteries that have not been properly unveiled. So that type of thing I talked about, the diabetology and other things, gynecology and pediatrics and everything, we can start with this healing system, because nothing is impossible. Here you have to understand, the healing system for spiritual healing persons, that will be intensive course and training. And persons, those who are engaged in Ayurveda, Siddha, Allopathy, Yunani and other systems like I have already mentioned, crystal therapy, aromatherapy, color therapy, magnetotherapy, radioesthesia, then musical therapy, that of other therapies are there, cosmic abundance, cosmic therapy, reiki therapy, pranic healing, lot of systems are there. Those who are classified, are there any practitioners of medical systems of healing here? Raise your hands. Medical systems, only two. Non-medical systems of healing like crystallography and other alternative systems of healing, microsystems of healing, what are you? Okay. If you are having both Ayurveda and pranic healing, but taking into consideration pranic healing and having the additive of this thing is very proximate. From Ayurveda to divine healing, it has a more distance when compared to the distance between Reiki pranic healing and this divine system of healing. So, forgetting yourself as an Ayurvedic practitioner, except at your home and your dispensary, you have to take into consideration that you are into pranic healing and you have to proceed. Are there any other people who are academicians and other normal professionals or retired people and social service interested or counseling people who want to learn these things? Yeah. So, this is how we have to classify these people. The syllabus, the common for the three things we have to study. One is the energy source study. It is known as energy source study. It is a study about the energy resources and the energy resources management. That is common for all. That is a common subject. And second thing, anatomy and physiology of human body and functions. Spiritual anatomy as well as the peripheral anatomy. I have already told about physical, microphysical and paraphysical. I have already briefed it in the previous lecture. So likewise, these subjects are very common for all people. After completion of these things, spiritual healing persons, their diagrams and structures are very different. And other people in the other systems of healing, either proximate distant systems of healing, either materia medica healing or non-materia paramateria medica healing. Paramateria medica healing is not with materials but with energy. Materia medica, that deals with materials like herbs, toxins and other things. So for that we have to classify. I think that the next thing will be the classification of the phylum level of each and every participant here. So this time we have taken the heart. So heart is very significant because apart from the physical governance, heart has three governance. One is the physical governance. Each and every part is activated by the supply of prana. Prana, prahrishena niyate anena iti prana. As everything is led by the force that is known as prana. Prana is not oxygen. Prana is any force. Oxygen is having that type of force for us. So that is known as oxygenesis. The whole systems of the cosmos, there are two types of major creations. One is aspirate and respirate. Most of the creatures, they respire, and there are hundreds of creatures which don't respire at all. Some respire through nostrils, some through beak holes, some through gills and some through pores like plants. And the devas, the celestials, they don't respire at all. They are having intra-respiratory system in which they rotate their own energy on the basis of rotary kinematics. So celestials, they exist by that. So the prana, the vital energy for supply of the essential force which have been extracted from the nutrients. Food is sent inside. Food is assimilated in the form of nutrients. Nutrients give a nutrient vital breath or air, which is known as oxygen, which is carried by the process of oxygenesis throughout the body through blood. So that major function is done by prana. So that is physical governance. So first, before learning your heart, just please close your eyes and just think. See, understanding it as a mamsapinda, a flesh package, is entirely different from understanding the function and envisioning divinity inside it. Just close your eyes. Whatever I say, I am going to say only in English. Sanskrit things can be learnt afterwards. Just you close and imagine your heart that you are taking food and the food is going, just imagine inside your mind. All realizations, they start with the dreams, then dreams are translated into imaginations. Imaginations result in realizations. Imaginations, for truthful things, they are realizations. Mere imagination is an air castle and nobody can reside inside it. And just consume some food. And don't concentrate about the variety of food because you will be diverted. So just some food is taken inside, it reaches your canal, the intestine, everything is sucked and made into a fluid in the form of rasa, and that rasa that gives you that essence, quintessence of the nutrition, that gives you energy, that energy is transmitted into all parts of the body by the heart, and this is done by God or the divine spirit inside. Now you have got 2% of energy to cure heart diseases by analyzing this thing with life. Study everything with life, thinking that the heart is some package inside your body, think that heart is everything, that is life. Whenever you deal with any part of the body, either it is in urology, nephrology, gynecology, pediatrics, neurology, neuropsychology, neuropsychiatry, neurochemistry, neurobiology, neuroontology, neurometry, whatever may be the science, the concept of thing must be treated as God. Think it as universal form, think it as a complete form, then you will get energy. Now, if you have thought in the simpler process which I have told, 2 marks you have got for healing. This is enough for getting 2 marks. So, this physical governance is done by heart. Number 2, emotional governance. More than the emotional governance, the emotional sequential order and impact, it is an emotional reactant. We cannot say that the heart creates emotions. It is evolved from the mind. The sukshma akasha inside, it is known as dharakasha. I want to just clarify one thing from Brahma Sutra, and somebody, they raise one prima facie question to Vedavyasa, where is the place for soul? There is nothing known as soul. If there is soul, is it a component of a compound or a compound full of components? It is neither a compound with components nor a component for a particular compound. It is a separate, a distinct element. So if there is such a distinct element, and how does it reside inside the body and activate? And I have discussed in one genetical engineering seminar about the place of soul. What happens to soul at the time of pregnancy, how your second soul gets inside, and what is in spermatology, the dealing with souls where there is multitude, and what happens to soul at the time of cloning, and what is the connection between DNA and soul. So these things are discussed in genetic engineering, these things. So likewise, the Vyasa says, Hridihi, just note down the soul. Hridihi, the soul is there in Hrid, that is in the heart portion. Then somebody, they ask some question, if soul is inside the heart, then now they are making pacemaker, they are making cardiac surgery, and they are making artificial heart and artificial operations also. At the time of this, how the heart will function, and soul must be in such a position where it cannot be touched at all. And if it is there just within a fleshy package, which is being operated by modern surgeon, it is not acceptable. So the Shastra says that Hridaya is of 2 types. One is Hridaya, the name of the Hridaya is because it is named after the Akasha, the ether inside, the Chidakasha inside. Do you know that? For example, there are a lot of things like Tilak University, which is named after Tilak. Likewise, Hridaya is name of the Dharakasha, the ether inside. It is a space, it does not consist of anything that is fleshy, anything that is materialistic. It is paramaterialistic, impalpable realm, which is known as ether. In Sanskrit, it is known as Chidakasha or Dharakasha. For that, 1 mark for you. In that place, the soul resides, and everybody is asking, then if it is at one place, how it can activate the whole body? Aviro adhashandaravat. This is the second sutra. There is no contradiction like chandana. Chandana, when applied to a particular portion, the chillness is conducted throughout the body. Likewise, by the dharma bhuta jnana, by its radiation, varagra deepavat, like the light is placed in one particular place, which cannot permeate, but it can permeate with this radiation. The tube light, it cannot permeate, but the efflorescence from the tube light, it can permeate within the whole system. Likewise, the soul being residing in the Dharakasha, it can permeate the whole body and activate as per the shastras. Avirodha Chandaravat is the second sutra. So now we have to understand that Hridaya is the name of the Akasha ether inside, and there also it is having one more tool. That one more tool is known as internal organ Mana. If it thinks, it is known as mind. If it decides, it is known as intellect. And if it makes a vow to act at the time of action and activation, it becomes a Chitta and Ahankara. You think, that is mind. You design, that is known as intellect. You confirm it, that is known as Chitta. When you are having your altruistic egoism to execute it, that is known as Ahankara, then you execute it. So before execution, pre-action phenomena consist of four stages. One is conception, second is designing, third is planning, and fourth is determination or will to execute, fifth is execution. Somebody is seeing a silver bowl inside. This is a silver bowl, it is mind. This silver bowl is 2000 rupees, that is the intellect. Why can't we have it? That is Chitta, suggestive mode. Yeah, you can have it. This is Ahankara. Then you are just taking it and you are doing a very great kleptographic design to keep it inside your pant or somewhere else, and you are just moving the place out. Like that. There is a predetermination stage in thought. So this Dharakasha consists of soul. Soul vivifies the mind and other internal organs. Then it reflects in heart. So heart is the impact. It is the impact organ of all emotions. Whenever you feel happy, whenever you are afraid, whenever you are in perplexity, whenever you are in anxiety, whenever you are in turmoil, whenever you are in confusions, at various stages of your mind, the heart responds by increasing its palpitation, by oozing out in the form of perspiration, by stimulating and scintillating you in the form of horripilation. So if all of these emotional outbursts are managed by heart, so heart is the substratum of your emotional things. Okay, now you just close your eyes and then just listen to what I say. I told it in a very elucidator manner. Let me brief it. First, there is, you know, the heart. You must have seen in all pictures and other things. There is a small, lustrous, resplendent, sukshma akasha ether inside, and that is what we call the peripheral center of consciousness is anahata, and the deeper inside is Dharakasha. Between the package of anahata and Dharakasha, there is atma, mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankara, that we will decide later. First, you are seeing a resplendent ether, a space which has nothing but light, and there is a small spark with infinite glory and with infinite transcendental effulgence, prakasha, swayam prakasha, sarvajna, chidatmaka, anandamaya. We are seeing that spark, and that spark is connected with mind. Mind, you give form to mind. It is known as personification. You give form to mind. Whenever you are giving forms to formless things, that is for easy apprehension, adaptability and transmission, and that is not a fertile imagination or mere hallucination. If something really exists, giving form to something which does not exist, it is fertile imagination and useless. It is existing, but the form is either not available, or it is too crucial to determine it, or it is totally invisible, or the form is too subtle, you personify with form. You imagine the Dharakasha and a spark of the soul, and also a subtle spark of mind. You imagine a big dot, from which one dot comes, that dot is rotating, that is known as the capricious mind. Then that capricious rotating mind is fixed in an orbit, that is an intellect. Within the orbit it proceeds, that is known as a determination chitta. Then it oozes out in the form of action, either by seeing through eyes, or by hearing through ears, or by tasting through your tongue, or by gripping something by your hands, or by moving mobility through your legs. You think akasha, a broad space, and a bigger spark inside it, this is a soul. Then also think about a small spark, rotating spark, mind. Then the rotating spark, it must be fixed in an orbit, that is mind, that becomes the intellect. Then it moves through determination and it executes in the form of action. So just there is a space, there is a bigger dot, there is a small dot that is rotating, that is fixed in orbit, that is moving, started moving, that is coming through your eyes, imagine. That is coming through your ears, that is coming through your nostrils. that is coming through your touch buds in the form of pores in the body, from the taste buds in your tongue, through your limbs, as well as the energy flow. For this, 2 more marks, 4 marks we have received in the process of healing. One. And number third, if you control the mind, for example, you know that anything that is beyond our control, that can be controlled by a superior status which is activating it. Could you follow that? Anything can be controlled only by a superior force. That's why I explained in the science lecture, there are 3 types of people. Persons who are looking things in a lower level, persons who are visualizing the same thing in the equivalent level, persons who are seeing from a higher level. Could you follow that? Persons who are seeing things from a lower level is a common person. That is a society. There are 3 S. One is the society, second is the scientist, third is the seer. So the social community, the scientist community and seer community. The social community, they see everything from the lower level. They know that it is acting. They cannot answer why it is acting, what it is acting, and how it can be put to an end, how it can be augmented if you want, how you can throw if you don't want the society, they do not know. The equivalent envisioning is done by the scientist who can know at least some basic things. But they cannot understand the head and tail. Head, where does it come and where it ends, they cannot understand. The portion between these 2 things, they can analyze. The spiritual people can understand the 2 things. One is the teleology, the purpose or end, or ontology, the study of the fundamentals. It is apprehendable only by the spiritual people. So, could you follow that? Likewise, if you want to control heart, for these 2 marks, if you want to control heart, or heart diseases, or emotional control, whatever you want from heart, you must take a force which is not equivalent to heart, or which is the heart itself. The same heart will not provide you the potency or the valency or the energy to cure itself. Or any part of the body like brain, somebody says that I will apply my brain. It is a different arrangement or configuration of flesh. If the flesh is arranged like this, and if it pumps the blood, that flesh is known as heart. Same flesh is like this in the cranium ball, within the cranium fluid, instead of here valves. Here we are having valves and vessels. There we are having nerves and neurons. What is the difference? A different arrangement of the same flesh in a different fluid, cerebrospinal fluid. Here it is blood. So different arrangement of the same thing, same wine in a different bottle. It cannot come for rescue. So understand this concept for getting 2 marks. I think that you will get a pass mark within today's lecture's finishing. 40 marks out of 100. Anything that cannot be controlled by itself. Rule number 2, anything cannot be controlled by something which is equivalent or equistatus with that. So we are taking the potential governance of the factors of mind and strong determination now. Our belief in the super mind and hypercomputer of the universal network, the God, seeking his guidance or blessings or the sources in the form of nature and consciousness, we are going to take their support in developing the energy sources. So how to think, what to think and how to gain, we have answered 3 questions resulting in 6 marks. Follow that. Now, why to study cardiology? Already, there are some areas, you know that in a mechanical device, there are 3 parts. One is a delicate part. And second is a sturdy part. And the first thing is the primary or vital part. For example, if there is an engine, the engine, the vital part is the energy supply. Apart from which the sturdy parts are there. What are the sturdy parts? The parts that are having proper endurance. That is the durability, their working efficiency, and nature of withstanding challenges, pressures, collisions and contacts. If you do like this, it is friction. If you do like this, it is contact. If you do like this, it is collision. So starting from a friction, ending with a collision, there are different challenges. Like mechanical challenges, we are also having life challenges. We are having friction in relations, friction in financial sufficiency, friction in knowing things. And also comes contact is there, and contact benefits and ill effects are there. And collision is the area where we are getting fatal damage, or where we are getting fatality itself. So in these areas, the sturdy part of the mechanical device, it can withstand these things. And your freak, there is a freak and delicate mechanism inside those things, operation systems, which cannot endure. So that which cannot endure at all, that which can endure towards a particular limitation and demarcation, that which can endure anything, there are three things like that. So what is the position of heart? I want to say it differs from persons. For some people with good balance, physical, mental, intellectual, spiritual balance, it is a sturdy mechanism. For some people, it is a reasonably sturdy mechanism. For some people, it is a freak and useless mechanism. So this thing cannot be generalized. So before you are going to heal, this one mark you can put. Before you are going to treat the hearts, you must understand, sturdity is of two types. One is the person's sturdity. Second is the person's organic sturdity. Organic sturdity deals with the heart and its sturdity with functions. You follow that? The second type of sturdity is a mental sturdity. If a person is to be treated who is having a heart disease, even though the person may be having 10% of heart disease, if the mental sturdity is more, that person must be treated as a person with a very, very poor heart sturdity itself. Because the total impact of a person's sturdity or impact level of a person's disease is counted along with the mental balance and sturdity of a person. Even for small diseases, even for ant bite, there are people who are afraid as if they are snakes, and people who are considering even scorpion and snake bites as ant bites, the strong determination they also exist. Before treating a person, you must either give them confidence, care and courage, three C's. Confidence is not always positive. If somebody is going to die, giving confidence is not that saying that you will live for 100 years. Saying that you cannot live and the possibility is very limited, and asking the person to execute the maximum things that he can do in his lifetime, that is also a confidence. In Srimad Bhagavata, when Parikshit Raja was cursed to live just for 7 days, nobody were engaged in the process of doing some rituals for augmenting his longevity. They have understood that is 7 days, and 7 days the maximum thing that he can do, he has done, and that has resulted in the formation of Srimad Bhagavata Mahapurana. Likewise, confidence is not false hope. Confidence is not false hope. Confidence is not consolation. It is insulating the person with more endurance and more capability to bear and withstand circumstances. So you have to give confidence, care and courage. Courage, to give confidence, you must have insight. Because by seeing the peripheral, what confidence you can give? That's why doctor says, this is what I know, rest of the thing God knows. You surrender to God, but pay the fees here. So confidence can be given only by people with insight. Courage can be given by only people, those who have knowledge. Care can be given by people only those who have heart, who have the softer emotions of affection, altruism, humanitarian base, love for others, love for human beings, love for the affected and downtrodden people. So, to give courage, you have to develop your intellect. To give confidence, you have to develop your spirituality. To give care, you have to develop your humanitarianism. Your blend of three things will be going to be a very successful, infallibly successful healer. And we are going to, in the next class, I am going to give 10 exercises for developing courage, for developing confidence and developing care. So, heart, it is very essential, because I told most of the people, due to 5 reasons, they are having heart problems. Number one, now most of the people are in a dilemma. They are not clear whether they are eating food or manure or artificial fertilizers. That much, the artificial fertilizers, they are totally occupied the plantation kingdom, and in the pretext just having a small calcium, urea or potassium, they have been consuming vegetables. Now in the form of vegetables, they are consuming the same urea, calcium, potassium, nitrate and other things. So these things, what is the connection between this and that? These fertilizers, they are capable of eroding 2 major things. One is magnesium, second is iodine, which are very much essential for governance of your intellect and balance. And I am going to teach you the substitute for this thing, how to create your own iodine, that is not through Tata iodized salt. I am going to give you a substitute by Smara Sukta and Medha Sukta, and those who are in the Vedic tradition with Vedic mantras with Swara, and Agama mantras are also there. God has given everything for all. Nobody is excluded. It has given a tongue for a fox which can lick and take the soup, and a long beak for a crane which can get inside the bowl and it can drink. Both of them they can drink, but with different tools. Likewise, Vedas, Agamas, Puranas, they have different tools for different level of people. Even the great Vedic Brahmins, they have their own sources. Even a common layman, he has his own sources for the same benefit. So the Vedas are impartial. And giving different type of things to different type of people is not partiality, it is prudence. A mother giving mixed food for a newborn infant, or milk for a lactic support for the newborn infant, or a grown child being given a very well cooked sumptuous meal, and a semi cooked meal for a person who is sick, and fruits and vegetables at the time of fasting or something, she is not partial, she is very prudential. Likewise, Vedas are very prudential, for they know the design of people and their capability, and nobody is denied with the result. The methodologies are different, they are getting the same benefit. So I am going to substitute with Medha and Smara Sukta the next time, or even 31st time here, I will be here for 2 or 3 days. And then it is a substitute for, there is a process, a lot of things are to be dealt. It is known as ontodietrics, kindly note down ontodietrics. In the nutrition science, there is very interesting phenomena, conversion and inversion. If unwanted things are getting inside, the resistance of the body, it can convert the unwanted things into wanted elements, like the synaptic pruning of brain. For example, if you are having over, that is what we call hypercalcite, in which the calcium is more. At this time, if the resistance mechanism is really pure and strong and potential, the extra calcium, it is disintegrated. It is either imbibed by the body and pushed out through the excretory system, or it can be refigurated in the form of some other things like potassium, like sodium, because they are all bivalent. So they can convert into something else, and they can invert the process through excretion. And also, this type of creativity inside the body is affected by our food habits, a deviation from the morality and pathway of some sort of precision which we handled in our yesterday years. You follow that? Likewise, iodine and magnesium, they need not be from vegetative sources. There are 4 sources for getting energy. One is vegetative, second is organic, third is chemical, and fourth thing is energy or spiritual sources. By means of giving a potential divine command to the mind or through the consciousness, immediately that orders the brain to cook a new nutrient which is required for your body. Likewise, they have tested, for example, lot of seers, they were doing penance without any food, just by sucking air inside, just by taking dry leaves. That's what we used to say. Human beings, they are consuming food through rice. Whereas these, the bovine kingdom like cows, they consume the straw and they work more and they give good milk. And these people, they eat the rice, drink also the milk, and they work with nothing. Because it is a ratio. We are also having execution skill. Not maybe a hard work like an animal, but we are having also a smart intellectual labor which we can do. So the proportion of the work, maybe the work may be different. I don't ask or I don't want the human beings to pull carts like bullocks. I am not specifying the work, nature of work. I am specifying the proportion of work, either with your brain or with your knowledge or with your soul or anything else. The proportion is not there. Because a great tradition has been put into lapse, that we have to revive again. We cannot do in the society. Within a countable members, we can readily impart those who deserve and those who are desirous. So, from vegetative sources we can get. From organic sources we can get through animals and other things. As a non-vegetarian source. And chemical sources, it is very dangerous because chemicals, they don't react with the body with salubrity. And fourth is a spiritual source by which it has been tested also. We can also test for any deficiency, like a calcium deficiency inside the body or iron deficiency in the body, either as an additive with the iron tonics like bricks, etc., or directly consuming the spiritual energy itself, we can see wondrously how that energy particles are made. But at the stage of hyper deficiency or getting into impending dangers, one must not start this practice. For the beginning level, it is okay. Somebody is about to die or about to be admitted in CCU or ICU. Taking them for experimentation is experimenting his own life and your future. So for beginning areas, it is very there. And apart from that, you can test on yourself in the case of failure or insufficiency with the medications. So these food items which we consume, they have eradicated the balance of emotions through intellect. What is the connection between this and that? As that balancing is lost, human beings like shock absorber and suspension in vehicles, they are also having suspension and shock absorbers. What is the shock absorber of mind? That is confidence and courage. That is not a bravery with a sword and fighting. That type of bravery is something to withstand occasions. And the second, what is the suspension? Suspension is faith. Faith is the suspension of human life. And faith that is coupled with courage, that is knowledgeable courage, not blind courage. I am very brave. How? I will stand before a running lorry. That is idiocy. That is not courage. Any knowledgeable, sensible, productive type of courage, which is either good to you or also to the surroundings, that must be there, coupled with faith. So faith is your suspension. Due to that mental imbalance, which is caused by the physical nutritional imbalance, which is caused by the erosion of magnesium and iron, which is caused by the kali, which may be caused by the fertilizers and the consumption and the food habitation variation and aberrations within the human being, which has been caused by the so-called imprints of the Maya Samsara, the illusory circles, the vicious circles of illusion that has contributed that. It is the hierarchy of the causative table or causation tables. So, heart is affected because we have lost these two things. Unless these two things are decided, deciphered, designed and applied or directed with the people, merely doing all of the other things like I have made the pacemaker, I am doing bypass surgery, I am doing artificial heart surgery, artificial heart implantation, these things are wrong. And these things are for interim benefits. For eternal benefits, the suspension of faith. Due to lack of faith, what happened? Everybody is, if you don't have faith, you will get into three problems. One is ambiguity in decisions, fear and suspicion. If you have fear, you cannot proceed in any walk of life. If you have suspicion, you cannot maintain good relations. If you have ambiguity, you cannot take any decisions. So this faith, you are having faith, but misplaced faith. You are having faith. Human beings, we cannot say that they don't have faith. They exactly have faith on those who are not faithful. And they don't have faith on faithful persons. So it is a misplaced or misorganized faith. So to develop faith, I want to teach you Shraddha Sukta. And for developing this type of dhairya, confidence, there is Bhayaharana Sukta. Yata dhyoshya prativicha na bhibito narishyata evamme pranama vibhehe. There are four suktas. Whatever I am going to teach you, they are just within four or five couplets. Very simple. It is not like Pratibhatashreni Bhishanavara Gunastoma Bhushan, like that. I don't want to put into any type of trouble. There are simpler, sweeter, shorter and smarter versions of the Vedas which I want to narrate. That require proper Uchcharana and Anucharana. You have to get the printed copies or a writing of these things developed either in a magnified form. Because the Aksharas in the book, they are of two small font sizes. If you just magnify, you can just memorize it in a very derivable speed. So due to lack of this faith and confidence, these people, they have lost the balancing system in their life due to which the heart problems are there in more. So how many people are having heart problems? All people, they are having heart problems. Yes, and the heart problem types, non-fatal, fatal and semi-fatal. In which you die is known as fatal. In which you die daily is known as semi-fatal. In which we don't die but we are disturbed is known as non-fatal. So everybody is having a heart problem. Heart problem means it must not be necessarily with some parts of the heart. Any operation of the heart. So there are also two more divisions. I always used to say generally for diseases. There are two types of cardiac patients. Those who are already cardiac patients and those who are would-be cardiac patients preparing for cardiac surgery or cardiac medication. So everybody, because that has become delicate in most of the people, that endurance has been totally lost in most of the people. And what is the rate of the fatal diseases? the rate of the fatal diseases is 15% of the society, global community. Especially Indians are very sentimental. Even in movies, used to say, in Western movies, there may be a death or separation. They will cry, they will give two or three tears, then there will be a BGM, background music of a clarinet, saxophone or something else. Then these people, they will cry for 5 to 10 minutes with one song and one big these things, then jumping, shouting, everything will be there. Because sentimental exposure is more in Indians. So like this, their application with cardiac diseases and getting into the cardiac arrest or sudden cardiac cessation of a blood flow, it is known as sudden cardiac arrest. All of these things are very much abundant in Indian denizens more than the other people. So 15% of the world population and at least 25 to 30% of the Indian population, they are having fatal possibilities. Those who are dying daily is 62%. And 8% of the people, they are having normal non-fatal heart problems like palpitation, like some suffocation. It is cardiorespiratory. Cardiorespiratory. For example, eosinophilia, sinusitis, they are attached with heart operations but more oriented with respiratory systems. Such things are non-fatal at all. They are giving disturbance but they are not going to give such a type of impact which is given by the fatal things. We follow that. So, let us now contemplate into Hridaya. All of you, keep down your notebooks and pens. And if you believe me, believe, I have already told, faith is a suspension. Believe me, at least 60% of your heart problems will be removed in 20 minutes. Those who are present here, I don't know about others, or your healing Shakti, I cannot give any guarantee. Because that is not the greatest of my power or something, it is the greatest of my sincerity in which I am very much interested and very much love to teach and impart the knowledge and potency. That is the greatest of my genuine thought of imparting without any coronary. Imagine the coronary as a tube, like as a, let it be a green tube. What makes the difference? And there is left side, move it to left side, that is anterior descendant. Then beneath that there is a circumflex. You think that starting from your Sahasrara Padma or the crown chakra, the blessings and mercy of God, we are not deserving, or we don't deserve at all any blessing because we are not qualified. We must be pitied by God. On qualifications we cannot approach God and we can get no benefits. But just being the son of God and bringing bad name instead of bringing fame to the divinity, God must take into consideration with more merciful pity on us that His creation is so in a deplorable and despicable condition. So that mercy let it ooze from His divine mind and penetrate inside our crown chakra, passing through the Ajna and passing through the Vishuddhi. From the Vishuddhi, let it be passing through the right shoulder, passing through the right arm, and Karatala and Karanguliya, that is the surface of our palm, then it reaches the Karanguliya, the fingers of our right arm, right hand. Then circumflex you are touching. Circumflex is just beneath. This is, you just consider it to be a tube, like the capillary tube is there, pulmonary valve is there. So you consider it to be valve, tube, vessels and other things. I will just distinguish through a PowerPoint presentation or diagram in a different program. Then there is, beneath there are two main arteries and veins. One is the pulmonary artery and second is the pulmonary vein. Then second is the aorta. Then it deals with the valves of the body, valves of the body of the heart. There is the mitral valve, there is a pulmonary valve and tricuspid valve. Just the energy passes through the tricuspid, the pulmonary and the aortic and mitral valves of your heart. So this is just a common understanding or route map for your heart. 18 portions are there. Separately these 18 portions with their names and functions, next class we must prepare a booklet. Whatever I say, then you have to follow the booklet and understand. So understand that the energy passes through all of these parts. And second thing, in all of these parts, 10 major diseases are there in heart.
this 10 we can easily understand. There are four processes. You can note it down. One is the process of prevention. Second is the process of identification. Third is the process of supportive education. Fourth is the process of independent rectification. First is detection. Parikshan. Second is prevention, Nivarana. Third is supportive education. Sahakarana or Upakarana. Fourth is Dhvamsana or total extirpation of the disease. So let it be a small prarthana, which is also very easy. There are four shaktis. Nivarana shaktyai namaha. Repeat it.
Nivarana shaktyai namaha.
Harihi om.
Harihi om.
Nivarana shaktyai namaha.
Nivarana shaktyai namaha.
So we are worshipping. We just don't want to just, yes, I want to prevent. We are considering that a preventive energy with a form, with a divine form, and we are invocating. So that is known as Nivarana Shakti. Whenever you affiliate things with divinity, whenever you personify formless things, whenever you qualify things with infinite energy, immediately you are getting those things in hand. That becomes Hasta Gamya. There are three types of Gamya. Mastaka Gamya, Pustaka Gamya, Hastaka Gamya. So you can get everything in hand. So Nivarana Shakti Namaha. Let me worship the force of prevention. Parikshana Shaktyai Namaha. Now we are dependent. If somebody is having heart disease, there are three possibilities. Somebody must say the symptoms. I am having some pain. That is known as a oral record. And second thing is they must have taken some scanning or other thing, magnetic resonance, imaging and other things, the report that gives you the benefit. That is a document based or evidence based. It is oral evidence, that is documental evidence. And third thing is probe evidence or insight evidence in which you penetrate inside the mind and understand the disease. So to that level, you must get more energy. So instead of investing more energy and identifying, if the person says, or if you get some document, with that you can proceed. And in higher level of education in healing, without being told, even if there is nothing in the report, there will be something in your insight. We have seen lot of medical reports in which they say that they are having something, but the person suffer with nothing. And in which they say that there is nothing, the person, they are having pain and suffering. So those things are undetectable. So that shakti is known as parikshana shakti. Today at least 10% your parikshana shakti is augmented. But tomorrow it must not be drained by lack of continuity and lack of divine exercises that you are here prescribed to be a practitioner in the sincere system of following. So that is known as Parikshana Shakti. And the third thing is supportive, so that is Sahakarana or Upakarana. Upakarana Shakti Namaha.
Upakarana Shakti Namaha.
Repeat it once more.
Then
fourth is the Nirmula Shakti, or it is the Dhamsana Shakti, which extirpates, eradicates things. Dhamsana Shakti Namaha. So, all of you keep your notebooks in your lap itself, let it be your laptop. Then, can you repeat without seeing these four Shaktis? Yes.
Nivarana Shakti Namaha.
Prefix with Om. We must not run. There must be a particular mantra for that. Like RPM for records. If you misplay the RPM, then you will hear somebody's voice.
Om Nivarana Shaktyai Namaha. Om Nivarana Shaktyai Namaha.
Parikshana Shaktyai Namaha.
Om Parikshana Shaktyai Namaha.
Om Sahakarana Shaktyai Namaha.
Om Sahakarana Shaktyai Namaha.
Om Dhamsa ध्वंसन शक्तये नमः।
ॐ ध्वंसन शक्तये नमः।
ॐ सर्वशक्तिमते परमात्मने नमः।
ॐ सर्वशक्तिमते परमात्मने नमः।
यस, नाउ फर्स्ट आई हैव कनेक्टेड द फैन टू दैट जॉइंट जंक्शन बॉक्स लाइक ऑल शक्ति, देन आई हैव टू कनेक्ट दिस विद दिस मेन and this must be connected with the ultimate main, that with the transformer, that with the electric power station, thermal power station and electrical power station, isn't it so? So whatever the upashaktis that you are doing, whatever the sub-sources of energy, it must be affixed with the mega source of energy. So this, now we are qualified, now 2 marks. So 6 plus 1, 7 plus 2, 9 marks we have received in following this thing in a single day. But it is assured on continuous process, incessant processing of daily practice with sincerity. It won't take more than half an hour. You see, why you are sleeping 6 to 8 hours for working 16 hours. Why can't you spend half an hour for making the 23 and a half hours happy and peaceful? That is very reasonable. So now we are going to deal with the function. Please close your eyes. There are two blood circulations. One is the pulmonary circulation, second is the systemic circulation. Now I am saying systemic circulation. Don't think anything as blood. Don't think anything as blood. See everything as energy and see every energy as God. I am giving you two rules. See everything as energy and see every unit of energy as God. These two rules are very much essential for energy analysis. Kindly note down these commandments later. Now, in the systemic function, from the heart, it goes to arto, arteries, arteriole, then the capillary tubes, then the venule, then the veins and the vena lava, then it reaches back the heart. You need not memorize these words, you can memorize it later, but without memorizing the Sanskrit equivalents and the devatas inside as well as the English equivalents, you cannot practice these things. Apart from 40 marks pass mark, the other 60 marks are for theory. You have to memorize these things. So first it goes to arteo. So you make a big tube, subtube, sub-subtube, then a common capillary tube. Then from this side, clockwise, it moves towards the venules. First energy, it flows, it reaches a big tube. The big tube is known as arteo. Then they are divided into small root tubes. They are known as arteries. And from there the energy flows to arterioles. Then it reaches the capillary tube, big tube. It may be vertical, horizontal. You need not just make the anatomy very clear to your mind. Just think that it moves to small tube and big tube. It is just an inceptive step of understanding the functions. Then it moves to the venules, then to veins, then to the vena lava. Then it reaches the heart again. Just for 1 minute. Om. Okay. By this thing, you can eradicate 25% of any blocks or stagnation, blood clots inside your body. No doubt it requires mantra and practice also, but by merely just contemplating, there is one major force which we call Acharya Anugraha. Acharya Anugraha that drives everything. That is known as Vyagra Kita Nyaya. A small worm, it cannot cross a stream. But if it clings to the hair of a tiger which can cross by jumping, it can just jump along with a tiger. That is Vyagra Kita Nyaya. That is how when Ramanuja was asked, how we are going to attain liberation and we are full of faults and we are full of troubles, how we are going to attain liberation? He answered, when the big trees like coconut, they are irrigated, then the sub-irrigation is done to the other small plants. Then it reaches even also to the grass as benefit. So, the Lord will bless the great Acharyas who are clinging his feet. We are clinging their feet. So, he will certainly bless me. You are under my lotus feet, certainly you will be also blessed. So don't worry and don't be suspicious. Likewise, we are having a tradition of our Acharya. That is why पुस्तके प्रसभाधीनम अनधीत्य गुरु सन्नुधिव नशोभन्ते सभा मध्ये जारगर्भैव स्त्रियः दट विच इज प्रैक्टिस ओनली फ्रॉम बुक विदाउट ए लीनियज ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल डिसिप्लिन दट विल नॉट शाइन इन अवर लाइफ जस्ट लाइक एन इलिसिट इश्यू सो वी आर हैविंग that type of lineage. I am connected with Vedavyasa Bhattaraka. They are connected with Srivatsanga Mishra. He is connected with Ramanuja. Ramanuja with Yamunacharya. And Yamunacharya with Mahapurna. And likewise Rama Mishra. They are connected with Nathamuni. They are connected with Shatakopa, Vishpakshena, Mahalakshmi, Narayana. So this is the lineage of our practice. So this practice, you are not only connected with me at the time of learning, you are connected with the ladder which takes you to the heaven. So that knowledge and that support that augments your efforts and wherever there are gaps, fill in the blanks, match the following and arrange the following in the which is in the jumbled order. Everything these mathematical works and examination works are done by the spiritual intervention. So daily you have to contemplate. First you must be having a good heart. Good heart is of two types. One is a characteristic determination. Second is a functional determination. Functionally you must have a good heart means strong heart. Then only you can see others. If a doctor prostrates before a patient, oh patient, please bless me, today is my operation, first operation, without your guidance, I cannot proceed. Then immediately the patient will collapse. Immediately he will be operated without the need of a knife. He will tear himself. Likewise, we must have a strong heart. I am afraid of blood. Either you are, there are three things. One, the first thing is fear. If you are afraid of those things, you cannot handle. And if you are having vijugupsa, aversion, so the blood vomiting is there. On seeing blood, I will vomit. Some emetic sense or unbearable sense, obnoxious sense. Obnoxious sense. That is known as aversion. If there is aversion, you cannot do that. Then if you are totally moved by emotions, you cannot do anything. To see a heart patient, immediately you must console. If you hug him and if you are going to cry with the patient, then he will be afraid. He will be in a position to treat us then. Is he being treated by our energy? He will take into consideration our health and he will give some tips to us and he will leave away. So we must be having a strong mind, strong heart. We must be also having a loving heart. Strong means it must not be so strong that it is merciless. And it must be having some sort of liberty from these three basic instincts. That is lack of love towards people. Consideration, if you don't have consideration, you cannot heal. Second thing, even if you consider a person, you must be strong. If you have any sense of aversion with patients or thing. So for example, somebody while entering into the hospital itself, they are allergic. Allergic to hospital atmosphere, allergic towards patients, allergic towards infectious patients. And allergic towards medicine smell. So all of these allergies, they must be eradicated. Just as normally a human being is there, a medical professional is there, just as these allergies are totally to be extirpated for a successful practice, for a spiritual healing also, considering things to be in aversion, obnoxious nature and allergic nature must be avoided. Then only we can cure. So daily, we have to understand this systemic. I have told about the two ways of flowing blood. It is known as the systemic circulation. You have to daily think about the systemic circulation. And whenever somebody is in inceptive heart block, I am going to just give you 10 major diseases. If somebody is having inceptive heart block, I have already told preventive, there is a Nivarana Shakti. It does not mean that, see, there are two major rules I have already told. What are those two rules which you have not written? What are those two rules? Can you remind? Seeing everything as energy and seeing all units of energy as God, right out immediately. And there is one more probability aphorism. It is known as the probability aphorism. Anybody can get any disease and anybody can get disease at any time. So thinking that I am hale and healthy, it does not mean so. Any person, whether you are having problem or not, you first make a good heart. Good heart is functionally good, characteristically good. Characteristically good means loving. Being beloved, affectionate to all, considering the miseries of others with great care and concern. So good heart means, there are two types of good hearts. A good strong heart and also that which is strong with a potential drive of mercy. So everybody each and everybody is having their own accident prone or disease prone area, and that can come at any time, and no disease can be underestimated or belittled. What is cancer? In one preventive oncology seminar I addressed, there is no disease known as cancer. Each and every part is operated by the neuro signal processing. When done of aliens, infiltration results in irritation. Irritation gives you ulceration. Ulceration radiates the part and deepens it and permeates to the other portions. Before this permeation and radiation happens, the NSP neural signal processing, it must control the disease. That stage of treacherous disease which cannot be controlled becomes cancerous in nature. So cancer is the name of the nature of a disease. Uncontrollability of a disease, it is not the name of a disease. So no disease can be belittled. I am going to give you the sutras, like Brahma sutras, sutras of healing. There are 300 sutras of healing. Sarve vyadigrastaha. All are having their own diseases in the incubation layer, or in the innate stage, or in the latent stage, or obvious stage, or fatal stage. It may be different. Everybody is having their own diseases. When they are ruled by resistance, all the other subjects, the denizens of the disease kingdom, they are submissive. And when the counterparty comes for the ruling, then all of the other body resistant elements, they come for subservience. So it is a combat. It is an eternal combat war happening inside the body. So the disease causing germs, they did not come from outside. They are verily available inside. So everybody is having a disease in various stages, starting from the latent stage to an obvious or considerable stage. And any disease can come to any person, and no disease must be belittled at all. If you think that it is a throat irritation, it may be both your throat irritation, or it may be a symptom for ulceration, it may be a symptom for a deepened ulceration, it may be also a symptom which, if uncared, may become permeation and radiation, developing into your throat cancer. So no disease can be belittled. These are all the aphorisms of healing. Likewise, we have to practice these things, and we can practice this flow daily. If you practice this, there are a lot of blocks which I am going to deal later. These blocks can be removed very smoothly if they are in the peripheral or inceptive level. In the beginning level, we can eradicate these blocks by preventive methodology, Nivarana Shakti. 60% of the heart diseases can be prevented for us. And how to transmit? See, transmission is not just like that. For example, if you are eating here, the same process you are adopting for another person also. How to eat and how to feed others? If you put it in your mouth, that is eating. If you put it in somebody's mouth, that is feeding. But mission and transmission of energy, they are not equivalent. Something to get to your mouth, that is the energy canal, is not as easy as you are going to do somebody who does not believe you. I have already given the list of varieties of people. Those who are attached to you, not knowing you, antagonistic to you, lot of things I dealt. So it requires a different study. Today I have just taught you the process of strengthening your heart. And the transmission methodology, there are two things. It is very essential. It is very, very essential. This is a great, wonderful invention of our spiritual kingdom. It is Atmavad Bhava. It is Atmavad Bhava, identity. If you think about your person, you make two conversions. One, you think that you are having the disease. This type of healing, I swear that in the world nobody knows, and only a limited esoteric parampara they knows. It is known as Atmavad Bhava. There are two Atmavad Bhavas. Thinking the person as himself. That is the own wisdom. In which you are thinking about your body, and in your body you are thinking about the heart block or something else, then it is known as superimposition or supraimposition. It is aropana or vyavasthapana or samsthapana. It is aropana, vyavasthapana, samsthapana. Suprapositioning. Like juxtaposition, it is known as suprapositioning or supraimposition. So you are thinking your body, and you are bringing the form of that disease or disease affected area inside your body. You are removing that. It is just like a remote. Remote has a significant resemblance and identity of operations. If you press volume, then the volume button or the volume response, there are two things. One is the operator, second is the respondent, and it is operated in the remote. And who is responding? The device is responding, but there is no counterwise response. You know that only the operator can do that. If they are bivalent, both the operator and receptacle, they can do that, but it is only unilateral. It cannot be done otherwise. By pressing the operations of a TV device, you cannot change the remote. But by pressing this, you can operate, you can activate them. You know that. So that which having similarity, like volume, contrast, picture, shortness, on, off, everything is there. The same configuration, this is known as configurative identity. That configurative identity is inside the television also. Where you are pressing this, you are getting that also done there. So that thing is mechanical and this thing is mystical. That is mechanical, this thing is mystical. By means of a yogic view or yogic power or by a deeper insight, you are thinking. See, by thinking that the other person's disease is yourself, that augments divine energy. There are two things for reducing and inducing energy. If you think the benefits of others as yours, your energy will be reduced. That car is the neighbor's. So many people are imagining that the car is theirs. At least with the avarice that they must possess that car. So, imagining something which is good from others, it is natural. And imagining others' problems as theirs, it is preternatural and supernatural. It is very essential part in healing. Most of the people, they treat that it is a disease for the other person. That's why the healing is more than 75% obstructed. And when a person, that must be a question. Yatha bhavo tatha bhavati. Whatever you think, you will become like that. So if I am thinking that I am having cardiac problem, for the sake of helping that person, will I get the problem by my imagination or by realization or by my contemplation? No, because it is tatkratu nyaya viparita. Today I am going to deal with that in Bhagavad Gita in today's evening lecture. Any person contemplating in any form, they will get the same effect. So Putana, you know Putana in Krishna's story. Krishna drank Putana's milk. So persons hearing this story, they must drink the milk of the mother naturally. But on the contrary, persons knowing this story, the Shastra say that they won't be born again this world to drink the mother's milk again. You follow that? Krishna is tied with a rope. If you think of Krishna being tied with a rope, according to this yata bhava tata bhavati, you must be also tied with bondage. You are not being tied. On the contrary, you are released from the already existing bondage. Likewise, if you are thinking that other's disease is yours for contemplation and curing process, you are not only curing his disease, unaffected by his disease, but also your already existing diseases are eradicated. That is known as tatkratu nyaya viparita. Any person's imagining that others' diseases are theirs, and by bringing their diseases into their own parts, then having it rectified, then immediately you are the operator. Who is the respondent? The patient is the respondent. Who is the operator? You are the operator. So you are bringing, with configurative identity, you are bringing the heart problem, pulmonary vessel infection. You are bringing that to your heart. Then you are imagining, then by the process you are curing. Then immediately, as the remote control, the operation system that activates the respondent, whatever you do here, immediately the person is done there. So the one more aphorism of healing is, you cannot cure the person within his body himself. That is a vital aphorism of healing. That is a thunder to all existing healing systems. You cannot cure any diseased person's disease in his body. You must shift or transplant his position to your own configurative identity, then get it cured, which will be having its own response in the other body's person by means of operative and respondent process of the remote controlling mechanism, which will give you not only the eradication assurance of his disease, but also your diseases, both mental, spiritual, along with the physical things will be eradicated for your broad-mindedness in which you are helping others. Could you follow that? Second, there is a pulmonary circulation of body. So keep your notes and just, you can, I think that you can shift your leg positions to make more comfortable. And I have already told about the systemic circulation, that is the outer circulation. In the inner circulation, there is a pulmonary circulation. So it starts from heart, from the pulmonary arteries, it reaches the lungs, then pulmonary veins, then it goes back to heart. Very simple. It must be very essential because it will help you in pranayama and it is a cure for cardiorespiratory diseases. Why I am telling these two things? Those things are cardiac diseases. These things are cardiorespiratory diseases. So close your eyes and from your heart, the blood flows to the pulmonary arteries. It reaches the lungs. You can imagine two lungs with good contraction and expansion, throwing all the dirt, dust and all other unwanted tinsels inside. And your inhalation always brings energy and you exhale all unwanted elements and you throw them outside your body. It reaches your pulmonary arteries. Yes, it has reached. Then it is just moving towards the lungs. It fills the lungs with energy. Whatever the toxins, unwanted materials, wastages that have been seen inside, totally by the divine will, by the divine command, by the purity of your mind, at least the interim circumstantial purity today and now, and the natural blessings of the spiritual ecosphere here, in the presence of great visible and invisible personalities, you are qualified to throw everything out of your lungs unwanted, then it passes through the pulmonary, yes, then the veins, then it reaches the heart again. So this is very much essential for treatment of cardio-asthmatic or cardio-respiratory diseases in total. Then, let us take 10 major diseases you can note down. 10 major sources of cardiac diseases. One is the coronary, general, first is the heart disease. The structure of heart itself, that may be deficit. Heart diseases. And second is the coronary diseases, coronary circulation diseases. And the third thing is myocardium, fourth is pericardium. Pericardium is the outer surface of heart, bahiravarana. And the antaravarana, that is known as myocardium. And fifth is the heart valve diseases. And sixth is the famous, very essentially you have to read this portion. It deals with the electricity or the electric impulses of the heart. It is known as cardiac electrophysiology. Infection and inflammation in hearts. Congenital diseases. Vascular diseases of blood vessels. And sudden cardiac arrest. Sudden cessation, unpredictable, undetectable. Cardiac arrest. Removed by the process of, now they are giving a new treatment. It is known as cardiac pulmonary refuscation. Now it is there. CPR. You can note it down because you have to replace the same thing by your healing. Somebody may ask a question, sir, I don't know about the anatomy, I don't know about the physiology. Just by praying, he is having a heart disease, whatever may be the part. Let him be cured. If I meditate like that, if we pray for him, would he be rectified from the heart disease? Are you going for any MBBS anatomy exam? Why we are compelled, forcibly rendered this type of knowledge? You see, if a person directly approaches the mercy of God without visualization of things, he needs energy for visualization also. Conceptualization. visualization and materialization of energies. Conceptualization of energy is what is heart and what are all the functions. These are all concepts. Then visualization, what is this heart and what is going on there and what must be there actually, the actual and unactual positions of the patient, that must be envisioned. And the third thing, materialization. Materialization of energy in the form of cure. Do you follow that? It's very simple. Divine energy should interact only through you as a mediator. If you want divine energy in its wholest sum, you want divine energy for all of these things. You want divine replacement for all of things. But we are not good receptors for more divine energy. To get more divine energy, you have to work more. We are amidst a materialistic atmosphere and we are prone to errors, mistakes, offenses, sins and crimes in respective proportions. And even if not now, we are a bundle of collection of various impulses and imprints of our yester births. So Agami, Sanchita and Prarabdha, the collection or the collective impulses and imprints, the collective imprints are known as Sanchita. And the Prarabdha is the distributive or the selective imprints or impulses. And Agami is about to come, that is known as the prospective. So retrospective and prospective imprints. Retrospective imprints are of also two types. One is the collective and second is the proportionate or distributive. So we are yet to do lot of things unwanted. We have done lot of things and we are doing. Just as Bhashyakara told. Krita kriyamana karishyamana ananta asakhya apacharan iman. So for those people, absolute torrential flow of divine energy, that receptivity is very low. If we have our own knowledge, that is also a divine blessing in disguise. There are two types of blessings. One is inert blessing and executive blessing, in which you need not do anything and God will take care. That is inert blessing. Executive blessing is God will do something. If you do something, He will execute through you. So through you, you know this anatomy, physiology and see with the parapenetrative vision, by which the divine energy, absolute energy requirement becomes less, so that you are reaching the level of accessibility to the divinity, you can become a good healer. If you are qualified for 5%, with the 25% energy, we can have a successful cure and health care here. And to get 100% of divine energy, instead of conceptualization, visualization, everything replaced by divine energy is impossible. I am talking about practical things. Possibility is entirely different from practicality. Anybody can dance if hot water or chill water is poured on their feet. But whether it fits or suits the stage or not, that is the question. So on emergency, on requirement, out of avarice, out of desire, out of plan, out of over-enthusiasm, you may commit lot of things. When coming to availability, possibility, probability, lot of other things are there in the society. I am talking about the practical vision. So understand these things, by which the executive power of energy, that is a divinity, is through you, by which less receptivity, besuiting your spiritual standards, can be comfortably received from God, which can give you real benefit. To develop some energy which independently cures the public or the affected person, it will take 20 to 30 years of service. And within that, lot of people will be lost and you will be reaching your dates. So, practicality.